In this video, we will learn about one of the boosting models, the light gradient boosting machine model, and implement it through coding. For your reference, the LightGBM model operates on the same principle as the gradient boosting machine model. So watching the previous video on gradient boosting machine may help in understanding. The LightGBM model is a type of gradient boosting machine model that combines multiple weak models, mainly decision tree models, to create a powerful predictive model. It exhibits fast training speed and high performance, especially effective on large datasets. The light in LightGBM comes from its efficient memory usage and speed. The LightGBM model can be used for both classification and regression tasks. LightGBM uses a leaf-wise tree splitting strategy, while most tree-based algorithms like XGBoost use a level-wise or balanced tree splitting method. The level-wise method minimizes the tree depth by maintaining a balanced tree during the splitting process. As shown in the picture here, each level of the tree is split into right and left nodes in a balanced manner. While a balanced tree structure is known to be more robust against overfitting, this method can take longer to train because it has to handle all nodes in a balanced way. The leaf-wise method used in LightGBM continuously splits the node of the leaf with the highest loss value, creating deeper and more asymmetrical decision trees. By persistently splitting the leaf nodes in the direction that minimizes loss, this method can more effectively minimize prediction error loss than the previously described level-wise tree splitting method. However, it can be more susceptible to overfitting, especially when dealing with limited datasets containing fewer than 10,000 instances. Gradient-based one-side sampling is a sampling technique used in LightGBM to increase training speed while maintaining performance, and it is useful when dealing with large datasets. In basic vanilla GBM, the gradient represents the direction and rate of the steepest descent in the error function. Larger gradient values indicate higher prediction errors, meaning they are harder to predict accurately. Ghost performs sampling based on the gradient of each data instance, retaining all instances with large gradient values and randomly sampling instances with small gradient values. This means that the model focuses more on data with high gradient values that require more attention during training, while only selecting a portion of the data with low gradient values, that is, data with smaller prediction errors. This reduces the size of the training dataset, thus speeding up the training process. Let's examine Gauss with an example. Suppose there are 10 instances. We sort them in descending order based on their gradients and set the hyperparameters A and B. Gauss selects all the top data with high gradient values and randomly selects the lower data. The value of A represents the proportion of the top part with large gradient values, and B represents the proportion of the bottom part with small gradient values. If A is set to 0.2 and B to 0.8, 20% of the top and 80% of the bottom are selected, meaning all data is selected without omission. On the other hand, if A is set to 0.2 and B to 0.4, 20% of the top with large gradient values is entirely selected, and only 40% of the bottom instances with small gradient values are randomly selected. By applying this to 1, A, and B, we get a value of 1 when A is 0.2, and B is 0.8, and a value of 2 when A is 0.2 and B is 0.4, resulting in a twofold amplification. This way, the model is trained by focusing on the poorly trained data. Therefore, the model performance can vary depending on how the hyperparameters A and B are adjusted. Next, let's learn about exclusive feature bundling, one of the features of the LightGBM model. Before explaining exclusive feature bundling, let's look at one-hot encoding. One-hot encoding is a method that converts categorical data, such as names or labels, into a numerical format that machine learning algorithms can use. For each row, only the original category is represented by 1, and the rest are represented by zeros. For example, if we represent categorical data indicating colors using one hot encoding with three classes, red, blue, and green. Red can be represented as 100, blue as 001, and green as 010. One hot encoding is a very useful method for categorical data, but it represents only the relevant class as 1 and the others as 0. As shown in the example, each row has only one value as 1, and the rest are zeros. As the number of classes increases, the number of columns increases, leading to higher dimensionality. When most feature values are 0, they are called sparse features. One-hot encoding generates these sparse features. Handling these sparse features efficiently is crucial for memory and computation. And this is where techniques like exclusive feature bundling come into play. Exclusive feature bundling in LightGBM is a technique that groups features by leveraging the concept of mutually exclusive features. Mutually exclusive features are features that rarely or never have non-zero values simultaneously in the same data point. This means if one feature is non-zero, the others in the group are zero. To explain more simply, it refers to a set of features that cannot occur together in a single data point. For example, if a product belongs to the fruit category, it cannot belong to the clothing or cosmetics categories. Thus, fruit, clothing, and cosmetics are mutually exclusive categories. This technique processes features by grouping those that are mutually exclusive in the same data point. By bundling mutually exclusive features, the effective number of features is reduced, consequently reducing the memory footprint, and speeds up the computation without losing information. This slide displays the screen for coding the LightGBM model. You can find the Jupyter Notebook file on GitHub, where you can download it and execute it directly. Similar to previous AI models, we first import necessary libraries such as NumPy, Pandas, and the TrainTestSplit library. Then we load the Excel dataset. After assigning X and Y variables, we split the dataset into training and testing data, typically using an 80 and 20 ratio. To build a LightGBM model, we first import the LightGBM library. After importing the library, we convert the data into a dataset structure. Then, we put various hyperparameters into a variable called params. Here, multiclass is used for multi-classification. And since the iris dataset consists of three species, it is defined as 3. The learning rate is set to 0.1, and the maximum number of leaves for the decision tree is set to 31. Additionally, top underscore rate represents the proportion of data with the highest gradients in Gauss. And other underscore rate represents the proportion of data outside the top rate, with the default being 0.1. Then, we train the model using the defined parameters and the training data. As a result, when calculating the accuracy with the training data, we get an accuracy of 96.7%, and the same accuracy is observed when applying the testing data. You can create a simple code using the for command to check whether the actual and predicted species match. As shown in this slide, if they match, it will display true. If they don't, it will display false. Additionally, you can use the plot underscore importance command to visualize the importance of the features. This shows that the width of the petal has the greatest impact on classifying the iris species. Additionally, based on the obtained results, we can calculate precision, recall, and F1 score values. Furthermore, we can also obtain a confusion matrix. Reviewing previous videos on the confusion matrix might be helpful for understanding.